In 2016, the G20 economies alone will have a digital sector that exceeds $4.2 trillion. That's just the digital sector in the G20 economies. However, the networks enabled through the policies that come from here are also enabling the digital revolution to affect all other sectors, health, education, government itself, industry, is all affected by the enabling power of the networks. We always speak about innovation on the internet in terms of technology. But I must tell you, the current innovation on the internet is happening in its governance. We are all, as users of the internet in the world, as governments, as businesses, as academics, as technical people, trying to figure out how to govern this very powerful resource. I say sometimes the internet is like a powerful river that crosses boundaries and countries and people. And how do we manage rivers? Do we block them? We don't. We cooperate in mechanisms that allow us to build dams and bridges, various agreements on how to share water that allow us to all share that river. Right now, the internet is a powerful river that is actually changing industry and changing the world. I call it almost the Uberization of everything that is happening. And how we agree to govern it needs to have the same level of innovation as how we build it. Looking forward, I think we need to focus very closely on how to balance security with innovation and privacy. And this three-legged stool is a complex one to balance. Some would like to increase levels of security. Most of us do, because without security, the network cannot be trusted. Others would like to make sure that innovation is left permissionless and completely open. And they are right, because it is through the innovations that everything we do in the internet and in the networks beneath it is possible. And then many others would like to see that this openness and this security do not impugn on the privacy of the individual as they work in that network. I think the challenge will be in how we build technologies and policies that allow for these three elements to be balanced. And I think the difficulty further comes from the fact that our values are not all universal. So there are people who would value security over privacy, others who would prefer innovation to privacy. And so because we don't have a set of global common principles for how we do this in a transnational environment, because the internet crosses borders and it crosses the Westphalian nation-state model. And therefore, we need to find values above that that unite us and balance these three areas